Nelson Mandela's granddaughter lays wreath at Westminster Abbey to mark 100 years since his birth as Princess Eugenie leads guests at anti-apartheid events celebrating his life. A centenary celebration took place marking the birth of former South African President Nelson Mandela at Westminster Abbey. His granddaughter's Amaswazi Dlamini Mandela looked emotional and wiped away tears as she attended the event. She also laid a wreath by a memorial stone in her grandfather's name. The dedication was led by the Dean of Westminster, the very relevant Dr. John Hall, and attended by South African High Commissioner to the United Kingdom Nomathamba Tambo, who gave an address. Princess Eugenie looked glamorous in green as she led guests at the reception event celebrating the work of anti-apartheid hero Andrew Mlangeni. The royal, 28, beamed as she shook hands with Mr. Mlangeni, 93, at the reception at Coutts Private Bank in London on Wednesday night. Mr. Mlangeni, a former member of the South African Parliament, was close friends with Nelson Mandela and stood alongside him in his fight for equality. The men were also imprisoned on Robben Island at the same time. The activist was recognized at an event hosted as part of the Nelson Mandela 100th birthday celebrations this week. It comes days after the Duke and Duchess of Sussex attended the opening of a Mandela centenary exhibition on London's South Bank. Eugenie, who today announced she would be inviting 1,200 members of the public to attend her wedding to Jack Brooks Bank in October, looked in suitably good spirits as she made the appearance. Dressed in an emerald green silk dress featuring a boat neck and asymmetric hemline, the piece accentuated her waist. Perhaps having taken tips from Meghan, Eugenie wore the exact same pair of Aquazura 550-pound nude heels the Duchess of Sussex wore to her engagement photo call with Harry. With her brunette hair blow-dried into soft curls, Eugenie was seen beaming as she met Mr. Mlangeni. Other attendees on the night included Mobo Awards founder Kanya King, Baroness Floella Benjamin and musician Hussein Manaur. A whole array of events are taking place giving an insight into Mr. Mandela's journey from young anti-apartheid campaigner to becoming the inspiration for an international movement against South Africa's violent and oppressive system. It is based around six themes: character, comrade, leader, prisoner, negotiator, statesman, all made up of information and photo panels, along with films and archive items from different periods of Mandela's life. In 1962, Mr. Mandela, he was arrested for conspiring to overthrow the state and sentenced to life imprisonment in the Rivonia trial. He served 27 years in prison, split between Robben Island, Polsmer Prison, and Victor Verster Prison. Amid growing domestic and international pressure as well as increased fears of a racial civil war, President F.W. de Klerk released him in 1990. One of Mr. Mandela's fellow prisoners during his incarceration was Mr. Mlangeni, who stood trial accused of sabotage against the then apartheid government and spent 26 years in prison on Robben Island with Mandela. The 93-year-old told of how being faced with a collection of artifacts and pictures which brought back so many memories. He praised Harry and Meghan's visit, saying, "To me, it's an indication of the importance. I am hopeful that we will do more to teach the young generation about the history and especially of our struggle in South Africa, where we come from and where we are at present. This exhibition I think will help in showing the younger people."